Hello, you're watching Proactive. Mass Gold has completed drilling at the North Lake deposits on its wholly owned Preview North property in the Ronge Gold Belt in Saskatchewan. For more, I'm joined by CEO Jim Engdahl. Jim, good to speak with you today.
Great speaking with you, Stephen.
Well, Jim, maybe to start, what was the reason that Mass Gold chose the LaRonge Greenstone Belt area of Saskatchewan to build a gold company?
Well, there was probably several very good reasons. The first one really was Ron Nedelitsky built the company up and always loved the LaRonge Greenstone Belt for the potential that it had and the work that was done on it over the years. But along with that, Ron is a mining Hall of Famer and responsible for major discoveries like the Eskay Creek, Snip Creek, etc., and exceptionally well followed throughout. So that, in combination with the opportunity of what is developed in Saskatchewan, and this I'll give you just a very brief history. Saskatchewan is famous for a couple things, one of which it's the number one jurisdiction in the world to do mining out of 83 different countries right now. And that's mainly because of the political atmosphere, along with the rights holders in the area that we're working in right now. The Indigenous people are tremendous there in that particular area. That, along with the infrastructure that's been developed up there between 1950 and 2000, and that was developed as the uranium mines, the largest uranium mines in the world got developed further north, opened up infrastructure. That in turn opened up opportunities for more exploration. So from 1950 to 2000, there was seven mines opened up in that particular area. However, by the turn of the century, there was only one left operating, and that was the one in 91 that started, the CB Santoy that Claude Resources owned. Coincidentally, I happened to be a director of finance for Claude at the time when we poured the first brick of that mine. It's still producing today. It's the only one that's still producing today. And it has produced 1.5 million ounces to date and still has 1 million ounces in reserves and producing at the rate of 100 plus thousand ounces a year. But the other six or seven mines in that particular year all shut down before the turn of the century, mainly because the price of gold was running around $300 at the time and the economics didn't work then. But today, that whole picture's changed. As you know, the price of gold is six, seven times that. And the opportunity to develop and control what Ron believed would be an exceptionally good gold region to have control of. And so that's when Mass was formed in 2010 and up until now, been developing and acquiring properties and developing properties. And this is where we're at today.
So, I mean, looking back, Jim, what were your goals for 2021 and did you achieve those?
All right, we had three main goals for 2021. The first was to resolve a dispute that had been smoldering for several years on a joint venture on our properties with Golden Band Resources. And to give you the Reader's Digest version, that went to binding arbitration. And as of April of 2021, a judge ruled that we did own it 100% as a result of our contributions and the lack of the partner. And they were left with an NSR that we could buy out anytime for $1 million. That overhung our market for 4 or 5 years in terms of, does Mass own 50% or do they own 100? Well, the judge ruled that. So that was our number one objective. And I just joined the board for the company in 2021. And that was one of my key goals, to help get that over the finish line. The second one was to reach 1 million ounces in all categories that we would have in our properties. As of, I guess, December, with the final acquisition of Comstock and the resources, and that's closing as we speak right now, that got us to just a little under 1.1 million ounces. And our third goal was to acquire Contact Lake Mine, which was a former producing gold mine that Cameco started in 1992 and shut it down in 95. And so we also acquired that from the government. Cameco, when they shut it down, they reclaimed it, turned it back to the government. We happened to be in the right place at the right time. And in September of this year, we signed an agreement to get control of that property. And that's really was our three objectives for 2021.
Well, I mean, having achieved all of those, what's your goals for 2022, Jim?
Well, right now we are just, our first goal was to complete a winter drill program of 8,000 meters, which included our North Lake property, Point deposit, as well as some early work on the property we just acquired via Comstock transaction on the Preview Southwest. So we've drilled, I believe it was about 4,000 meters, 32 holes on our North Lake, which we already have just shy of 500,000 ounces. And hopefully we're going to get an expansion of that with that program. We drilled another 800 meters on Point, which is a historical resource that is there from previous drilling. And we hope to be able to bring that into the resource category as well this year, as well as some very key targeted holes on Preview Southwest on the Comstock property. And that's just finishing up as we speak. Another week and we'll be done our complete winter program. And we should start receiving results. We should have actually received some of them already, but the labs are kind of bogged down for a lot of, I guess, good reasons. There's a lot of work going on. So we should be starting to receive results of our complete drill program. So that was our number one project we had for 2022. Our second project really is to define what we have at Contact Lake, which is ongoing right now, and design a summer program that will complement what we find there. Now, Contact Lake, when Cameco started, they started with 500,000 ounces in production in 92. They shut it down in 95 after mining 188,000 ounces there. So we do not include any of that, what is believed to be still there yet, until we've finished our work and do a few key holes. So we hope to bring some resource back into the categories there. That, along with the expansion of North Lake drilling, as well as the Comstock properties, which added another 420,000 ounces to our portfolio, we hope to be able to expand that. So our target for 2022 is to reach 1.5 million ounces. We think with a little luck, we can maybe get really lucky and get closer to 2 million. But we'll know that. And once we're finished our winter and summer program, we'll do an updated resource calculation. And also we will complete a PEA report that we started last year. But subsequent to our starting, we acquired both Contact and Comstock. And so we've suspended it until we get a total view of what we have and be able to develop our complete hub and spoke model that we've developed that you can see on our presentation on our website.
Well, Jim, it looks like it's a very busy year ahead for you. But before we go, how do you see the value of Mass Gold in relation to your peer group?
Well, we see ourselves very undervalued. And I'll tell you why, Steve. We have about 1.1 million ounces. Our market cap's running about 16, 17 million. That gives us about, I believe, if my numbers are right, about $16 an ounce in the ground. Our peers are running $30 to $60 an ounce. So I think we're exceptionally undervalued with the amount of potential prospective opportunities we have in such a great geographic area, government-wise, indigenous people-wise, workforces that are available, infrastructure. I think we're exceptionally undervalued because of that in relation to our peers.
Well, hopefully if everything goes according to plan this year, as you expect, that value will narrow. But yeah, thank you very much for the update today, Jim.
Thank you.
That's Jim Engdahl. He's the CEO of Mass Gold.